Hello, Waltham. I'm Dr. Roz Rubin, CEO of Greater Waltham ARC, GWARC. And with me today are Barbara Dunker and Joanne Corbell, who are from our Adult Family Care Program, AFC. So let's find out what AFC is. Barbara, you are the program director. What is the AFC program?
So AFC stands for Adult Family Care, or it's also known as Adult Foster Care. It's a MassHealth funded program, and it's available to individuals who have developmental disabilities or a medical or mental health condition that requires daily care with one activity of daily living.
Yep.
For instance, the individual must need cueing and supervision for either dressing, yeah, eating, bathing, toileting, ambulating, or transferring on a daily basis.
Yep. So this family member is living with their loved ones, and they are entitled to a tax-free stipend.
That's correct.
Which is either $9,000 or $18,000 annually. What a wonderful support for these families. And of course, this is a Medicaid program, and the purpose of which is to keep that loved one, that family member, at home rather than a nursing home or another kind of group residence for disabilities.
That's correct.
So how do you, what are the qualifications that you would need to meet in order to become a receiver of this money?
Sure. So the individual has to be MassHealth eligible or already on MassHealth. It has to be MassHealth Standard or MassHealth Common Health.
Mm-hmm.
And again, that individual would need daily cueing and supervision at minimum with one of those activities of daily living. Mm-hmm. They also need to be unable to live independently.
Yeah.
And the caregiver, on the other hand, and they also need to be 16 years of age or older.
Okay, good to know that part.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The caregiver needs to be 18 years of age or older, and would also need to be willing to devote the time necessary to care for the individual. They need to, they can be a family member or a non-family member. One thing MassHealth, not yet anyway, it cannot be the spouse of the individual,
not yet,
unfortunately.
Right.
And it also cannot be anyone who's legally responsible, so the legal guardian. Cannot
okay.
be a legal guardian.
So in fact, these families are already doing that. They are already in their home caring for that person. So we're not asking, the program's not asking for additional time spent. In fact, that family member, elderly, disabled, et cetera, could be going off during the day to some sort of day program or
that's correct.
Even work?
Yes, even work.
Work.
And so the caregiver, while the caregiver needs to be there when the individual is at home, they also could continue to have a job as long as it was while the one they were caring
for
was away.
So as we say about the Adult Family Care Program, which started about 2.5 years ago, you're going to get money for what you're already doing. So a very interesting kind of support to these families. And as part of that, a care manager and an RN will do a home visit depending upon the level of care that's being given. And the home visit is done by an RN, and that is Joanne's job. So Joanne, this is not a usual nursing kind of job. There's no vitals, no meds, no wound care. It really is you coming out. And what do you do? What's the focus of the AFC nurse in that home visit?
It's more nursing oversight. It's education, support, advocacy for the individuals and for the family.
So you really could answer questions that they might have about a better way to provide nutrition, or but you would not really, or something more about safety in the home or whatever.
Correct. Yep.
And refer them to other resources, but not necessarily doing the nursing or the nutrition part or. So,
yes.
So it's, again, really kind of low key if you think about it, that you are there as a support, as a resource, and to really give this money to people who are already are doing this this job lovingly and keeping their family member safe and comfortable in their home. So I know that we have reached out in many ways to the community to make sure that people know about this, but we've gone to Joanne and Barbara have gone to Elder Fairs, and a lot of different health fairs and spoken with even elder legal people, investment people, and how can people who are interested who are watching today, how can we get you guys connected? How do we connect
sure.
you?
Sure, great, yeah. Eligibility begins with a phone call. We'll mm-hmm. have an interview on the telephone, so give us a call. We can help answer any of your questions and get a pretty good idea of the eligibility.
Okay, and there's a graphic that will give the contact information for that. And by the way, this program is about 9 years old. When we first began, and even now sometimes, people don't believe this is legitimate. It is legitimate. GEORG wouldn't do it if it weren't. And it is Medicaid money, again, not taxable. You do not have to demonstrate how you've used that money, whether it's not or it's directly for the person you're caring for. This is a real program with a terrific support to these families. So we thank you for doing that job. Thank you all. Thank you to Cable. Thank you all for listening today. And be in touch with Joanne and with Barbara at GEORG so that you might qualify and be receiving this kind of support from our agency. Thanks very much, Waltham.